celebrate the Lord this morning with me as we come into this Friday's edition of the Voice of Resurrection devotional. I believe, God, that as you share this word with me, that it will cause your prayer life to grow. Because as we repent of the things that hinder God in our lives, the strength of the Spirit increases in our hearts. Amen. This week we are talking about the things that make God angry, and we've only had time, to get into limiting God. And I want to finish today by reading Psalm 78, we'll read from verse 9. The children of Ephraim, being armed and carrying bows, turned back in the day of battle. They kept not the covenant of God and refused to walk in his law and forgot his works and his wonders. See, we talked about that yesterday. Our problems begin when we forget what the Lord has already done, and we magnify the moment as if God has not proven himself at all. Oh, beloved, let that sink in. I'll read. And forgot his works and his wonders that he has showed them. Marvelous things did he in the sight of their fathers in the land of Egypt, in the field of Zoan. He divided the sea and caused them to pass through. He made the waters to stand as an heap. In the daytime also he led them with a cloud, and all the night with a light of fire. He cleared the rocks in the wilderness and gave them drink as of the great depths. He brought streams also out of the rock and caused waters to run down like rivers. And listen to this. And they sinned yet more against him by provoking the Most High in the wilderness. And they tempted God in their heart by asking meat for their lust. Yea, they spake against God and said, can God furnish a table in the wilderness? Behold, he smote the rock that the waters gushed out and the streams overflowed. Can he give bread also? Can he provide flesh for his people? Therefore the Lord heard this and was wroth. So a fire was kindled against Jacob, and anger also came up against Israel. Why? Because they believed not in God and trusted not in his salvation. Amen. Beloved, read Psalm 78. It will help you get out of unbelief. As I pointed out earlier, you notice their problems started when they forgot his miracles. That's number one. The second thing that really angered the Lord is when they minimized his signs and wonders. Beloved, don't you ever do that. Don't you ever minimize his miracles in your life. How he delivered you in the past. They said, yeah, he brought water out of the rock. Yeah, he parted the Red Sea. Yeah. But can he provide bread? Can he furnish meat in the wilderness? Beloved, why did they think like that? Because when you size up the situation as a man, it will seem totally impossible. Wow, 3 million people eating meat in the middle of nowhere? How is he going to provide bread? That is what is called limiting God. The Lord said to me years ago, your mind has not been given to you to solve spiritual problems. Your mind is only designed to process things, and you are commanded to train your mind by the Word of God. So when unbelief arises, the Word will check that wicked thought. Yes, beloved, God proved it to them. He caused the east wind to come and brought quail in abundance. The Bible says he laid in heaps several feet high. And they could believe it, they rushed out and gathered it up and started eating. And nobody thought to say, wow, Lord, we are sorry. We are ashamed that we didn't believe you. No, they started eating like it was no big deal. And the anger of the Lord was kindled against them, and he killed them. Beloved, don't make God angry with your unbelief. Don't make God angry by limiting him. Don't make God angry by forgetting the things he has already done for you. Don't make God angry by forgetting his works. Don't make God angry by minimizing all his signs and wonders. Beloved, I don't know why things take as long as they do. I don't know why things are so difficult sometimes. I've experienced those things. But one thing I know is I have kept going. And one day what seemed impossible became so easy, became so possible is ridiculous. I know that every battle I have today will give way to miracles in my tomorrow. God said to us, every day we wake up, we ought to know that that day is already greater than yesterday. Tomorrow will be greater than today. We keep going, believing God, until we see the salvation of the Lord in the land of the living. So when life is asking you, can God deliver you? You said, yes. The God that saved your soul can fix your mess. Beloved, that's what you and I must believe. And then we will get along with God. Can God give you a job in a recession? Yes. Can God take care of you and your family? Yes. Can you live in a house? Yes. Can you have food to eat? Yes. Don't limit him. He has done it already and will continue to do it. May the Lord bless you this week. May the Lord help you go to church and worship with joy, knowing that your miracle is coming. He is faithful to you. We love you. We'll continue next week to study the things that make God angry, so you and I will avoid them. May the Lord bless you. Amen and amen. Bye-bye.
The Lord is waiting on you.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is.